We stand here today before God, our family, and our closest friends, making public our commitment to each other. I would like to recognize first that God is authority over my life. And as a child of God, it is my responsibility to recognize that all good things come from Him. Proverbs 18:22 says, "He who finds a wife finds a good thing." From my first conversation, I felt years of prayers had been answered. As I began to share portions of myself with you, where I saw brokenness, you saw beauty. Where I saw emptiness, you saw worthiness. Where I saw shame and embarrassment, you saw glory. Thank you for loving me and accepting me as I am, and being my helpmate as I grow into the man that God would have me to be. Ephesians 5:31 says, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. From this day forward, I promise to lead you as God leads me. I promise to protect you from every attack from any enemy, and remind you daily that you were created in his image and his likeness, that you are fearfully and wonderfully made, and that you are beautiful and perfect just the way you are. I promise to honor your mother and love your children as my own. I promise you my deepest love, my fullest devotion, and my tenderest care. I promise you today to love you, Patricia, as my wife, just as Christ loved the church. And just as Christ gave himself for his church, I promise to give myself to you as your faithful and loving husband.
I, Patricia, take you, Courtney, to be my lawfully wedded husband. You have shown me what it's like to manifest an equally yoked relationship. The calling on your life is solid and undeniable. That in and of itself is an answered prayer. You are a godly man with purpose and discipline. And while you may not know all of the answers right now, you seek God for direction and continue to move towards your vision. And you've asked me to be your wife by your side, and I accept that. I promise to consistently pray for you and with you. I will honor you and respect you. I will submit to you according to the word of God, and together we will live out Genesis 3 and have dominion over your God-given purpose. I promise to seek God to help me to stand by your side through good times and bad, to listen with purpose of seeking understanding. I promise to love and cherish our God-ordained union and to keep our marriage sacred. I look forward to basking in your unending covering, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. I vow to remember that marriage is ordained by God, and by the power and grace of God, the generational curse of divorce in this family stops today. The truth of the matter is, we all have some sort of trauma. And you've taught me that the value of trauma in a relationship is knowing that we can accept the person as they are, extend grace, and move forward. This is only one of the many lessons that you've allowed me to love and respect you with all of my heart and all of my soul. And so I'm honored to stand here with you before God to make these vows to be your wife. My prayer is that we continue to grow together, pray together, play together, and continue to work to build the kingdom of God as husband and wife from this day forward until death do us part.
Come on, tell him one more time.